Hello, YouTube. It's Body321 here. Back with another Pokemon Sword and Shield Crown Tundra video. So before we get started, don't forget to destroy that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new for more Pokemon content. And let's get into today's video. Today, we'll be bringing you guys a comprehensive guide on Dynamax Adventures in the Crown Tundra. Dynamax Adventures are a new feature introduced in the Crown Tundra, which you unlock fairly early in the story. They happen at the Max Lair, which is the fly point that I'm showing on screen right now. And when you go there, there'll be an entrance to a cave. And once you enter the cave, you'll be where I am right now. So you'll be able to talk to this lady who will explain them. So she says that to take part in them, you will use rental Pokemon and team up with three other trainers coming to a consensus on which paths to take, and you'll eventually find a legendary Pokemon, and you'll get Dynite Ore as a reward, and you'll be able to keep one of the four Pokemon you're able to catch. So you can either pick specifically from the three of the Pokemon you've chosen in the past to find, or you can pick anything is fine. So once you pick one, then it'll save your progress, and then in order to invite friends, you have to click the plus button on your controller, which will open up the menu to enter a link code. I'll put in the code that I usually use, and then you give them to your friends, like with the regular raid battles, and they have 3 minutes to join. And then you have the invite others or don't invite others. Don't invite others is if you just want to play with the AIs, but I don't recommend it. Since I don't have a few people with me, I'm going to delete my link code and just go invite others. So if you select a Pokemon, I selected to do Suicune, then it will likely make you the host of the raid, which means that you're the first person and you get to decide when to start the raid. Or it'll match you up with other people who chose Suicune. However, if someone chose random, it could also put them in the group, but since it's already been chosen to be Suicune, it will still be Suicune. So then you ready up, and once everyone's ready, the host, which in this case is a person named RC, will click ready, and then you can select from the rental Pokemon which one you want to use. You're probably going to want to use the one that's going to be best against the legendary, assuming you didn't pick random and you have no idea what it is, in which case just pick the best ones. And the one you pick will be replaced by a different Pokemon, and then the next person will get to choose from the remaining three. So I'm just waiting for everyone to pick, and yeah, we have a fairly decent team. So now, it'll show the layout of our Dynamax adventure, which is kind of like a maze. And you get to pick which way you want to go. And by using the right joystick, you can actually scroll through it. So since we're fighting a water-type legendary, I'm going to choose the electric path because you can switch out your Pokemon throughout the adventures for ones that you've defeated. And you have about 20 seconds to choose which path you're going to take. So now that we've decided, and everybody gets to vote, and I believe that, say, three people choose the left and one person chooses the right, then it's a 75% chance that you'll go to the left and a 25% chance that you'll go to the right. So once a path has been taken, a raid will start like normal. However, unlike with the normal raids, there won't be any shields because that would make it way, way too hard as you're using rental Pokemon that are only at level 65. And I believe the raid den Pokemon are also level 65. So as you can see, the first person Dynamax, whoever starts with the ability to Dynamax will rotate throughout the Dynamax adventure, so it'll be the first person who gets Dynamax it first in the first battle, and then the second battle, the second person will start with the ability to Dynamax, and so on. So you will take damage throughout these battles, and any damage you take will carry over towards the next raid den after this, and all the way until the legendary battle. and PP as well. So you have to conserve your moves, and you also have to try and avoid taking damage, which is why some moves like Reflect and Light Screen may not be a bad idea. You also only get 4 feints for the entirety of the Dynamax Adventure, meaning only 4 Pokemon can faint throughout all 4 of the raids that make up your Dynamax Adventure. So as you can see, we just defeated this Luxray, and I'll be able to catch it with a guaranteed catch, so there's no need to use anything other than a regular Pokeball, unless you want it in a special Pokeball, in which case use whatever Pokeball you want and it's a guaranteed catch. So now is when we get to decide if you want to switch your Pokemon or you want to keep the Pokemon you already have. On the left side of the screen, you can see what the other people have decided. The exclamation mark means the person wants to switch their Pokemon, and the dot 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 in the thought bubble means that they're still thinking, and if there's nothing there, that means they've decided they don't want to switch. So now, along the way, there are 3 things I like to call events. One of them is the backpacker on the left, who will give you an item. You'll give you a choice of 5 items for your Pokemon to hold. You get to pick 1. In the middle is the scientist, who will allow 1 person to switch their Pokemon for a random Pokemon. And the final one that was on the right was a pile of berries, and that will restore everybody's Pokemon's health by about 30. So now I skipped the other raids, and as you can see, we're over here now, and here's the berries that I was talking about. So as you can see, our Pokemon's health on the left just got restored, and now we're at the final raid, which we know is going to be a Suicune. So as you can see, it starts like the regular raid with the added music and a couple of animations. And now just going to be a regular raid, except it's going to be incredibly difficult because it's a level 70 legendary and you're only using a level 65 Pokemon that were given as rental Pokemon, which is why you want to always try and choose to get Pokemon along the way, face Pokemon that are going to be super effective against the legendary, because somebody on your team will be able to switch for that Pokemon and therefore eventually use it against the legendary. So, and I also always recommend Dynamaxing, because you'll be able to take out the Pokemon faster, and the Dynamax Pokemon will have more health, meaning that you're going to take less damage along the way, because you want to avoid going into the legendary with low health or fainting and losing a life. So we're almost done here. Suicune's at very low HP. And yep, there I took it out with a Max Lightning. So, just like with the other Pokemon, it's a guaranteed catch. So, I'm going to use a Dive Ball in case it's shiny. So, for shiny hunting, they will not show up shiny in the raids while you're doing it. However, on the next screen, they will. So, it can be different for everybody. Like, I might get a shiny Suicune, but nobody else in the raid gets any shiny. The odds of getting a shiny are 1 in 100 per Pokemon with the shiny charm, and 1 in 300 without the charm. So now, as you can see on this screen, you can look at the different Pokemon, and this is where they will appear shiny, not in the raid. So as you can see, none of the Pokemon here are shiny, and you can also choose to check out their summaries. So I actually have gotten 1 shiny from this, a shiny Blacephalon. I'll have a link to that video in the description. Yeah, so you can pick 1 and only 1 of these Pokemon to take home with you. If you pick the legendary, you'll never be able to catch that legendary again. So I picked the Ivysaur since I plan on shiny hunting the Suicune later. and it'll be sent to your box like normal, and you'll be prompted to save, and then you'll be given the option to keep a record of where you found it, so then it'll be one of those three options. If it's a new Pokemon that's not there, you'll have to overwrite one of the existing ones if you already have three, because three is the limit. And if it's one you already have there, then you just have to click yes and it'll keep it there. So I think that's going to be where we wrap up this video. If you guys found it helpful, please don't forget to drop a like and consider subscribing to the channel if you're new for more Pokemon content. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll be seeing you in the next one.